And then we go to Independence, and then we'll go up to Southwestern for that. Or I'm sorry, yeah, versus Southwestern. That'll be here. And that's Southwestern JV.
Think about this this stretch that the Tigers are in right now, playing Coffeyville, obviously, you know, the upper half of the East. Then you got Johnson, you got Highland back-to-back. These three games here for the Tigers, they can't get any tougher than that right here with those three lined up.
And on the 31st against Independence, it's Hall of Fame night.
Yep, Hall of Fame night coming up the 31st. And I know of one inductee. Randy, do you know the other inductees besides Darren Burroughs?
Darren Burroughs, Candace Wilborn. She's married now, got a different name from softball. There was a tennis one, Pablo, I believe, and then there's two more. There's a football player that played back when Bob Jordan coached, and I'm drawing
DJ Palmer? DJ Palmer?
DJ Palmer, yeah. But there's another guy. Huh. So there's five people getting inducted this year.
We'll have
very
more
good
on
class.
That. You bet. We'll have more on that as it gets close, and we'll discuss more of course, Hall of Fame night coming up here in a few weeks. 41-41, Tigers and Red Ravens all knotted up. We'll be back here in just a few minutes.
It's still just amazing. The kids that haven't played a whole lot, but they sure are just awesome. That's kudos to Todd for playing them all in the year. Give them all a minute.
Rebound.
Yeah, got to win rebounds.
Second half, got to win rebounds. Continue shooting the ball hot from the outside. And I think wear them out.
Yeah, I was gonna say something about defensive pressure.
Defensive pressure, just got to wear them out. Will that work?
Yep.
Shooting and defensive pressure. Attrition.
Been a whirlwind day. I made a flying trip to Menards. They had an unbelievable sell on insulation for my garage.
Did you get, how many did you get?
Came back to seven rolls. I hate doing that, but man, when you can save $40 on the whole deal. Oof.
I have to come up short, holler at me. I got a roll in there.
I got some leftover from a roofing job too that I'm going to use. But I want to get that garage closed in so he can ride his bike out there on his trainer. And just have a warm garage.
You're telling me can't be a weenie. 41-41. Tigers and Red Ravens knotted up here at halftime, and 20 more minutes of basketball to go. And Kurt, I think this could come down to a battle of attrition.
It sure could. You know, thinking about some keys to the game or keys to a victory for the Lady Tigers here, you know, in this second half of play. Obviously, they were able to start making some shots, and that was able to get them back on that run and get them on that 29-11. Not really a run, but 29-11. They got to be able to continue to shoot the ball well from the perimeter. Obviously, win the glass. They didn't win the rebounding glass in the first half. Got to come up with a way of doing that. And then how about just wearing out? Defensive attrition, I like that. You just got to find a way to wear down Coffeyville. Forced them into those 14 turnovers. 14 turnovers in the first half. Lady Tigers turned those turnovers into some points. So just wear them down. I think it's obvious that our bench is maybe a little deeper than theirs. And maybe get their legs out from underneath them. And then continue to putting the ball on the floor. Not only perimeter shooting, but continue to putting the ball on the floor as well. Driving through those tired legs. Getting them to reach. Getting to the free throw line. Making some free throws.
Yeah, and I think another one is they also can't let Cosper get hot. She's only got four points in the ball game. Averages 20. Got to keep her out of the ball game.
You know, and Randy had a key thing. You think about it, at that media time out there in the first half, Lady Tigers were shooting 41% from the floor, 9 of 22. They ended up the first half 37.5%, so actually shot a little bit better through that first half of the first half than they did the second. But still, were able to come back. I think the key to that was they forced all them turnovers and turned them into points.
Coffeyville will start out the second half with the basketball, starting five back on the court. Keplox, who again, a little illness there before the game. Hey, there's a turnover right there for the Tigers. Here comes Hannah Alexander for the layup. Got pushed underneath. I'm going to say it bounced off the bottom of the backboard and out of bounds. So Tigers can't turn defense into offense there.
I think maybe Hannah thought it was blocked or tipped maybe, but not the way the officials saw it. How about the pace of the game here? You can tell maybe both teams taking a little deep breath at just a different pace.
Another turnover. Ulrich tips it away and then runs it down for the Tigers, and Hannah Alexander, again, will bring it up for the Tigers and throws it away. So back-to-back-to-back-to-back turnovers to start the second half.
Completely different feel in the gym here coming out in this second half than where we finished the first half at.
Really need to come out and score on that first possession and had the opportunity to get it done. Cosper with the basketball. Drive to the basket, loses the basketball, hits loose under the rim. Hannah Alexander's going to pick it up. Hannah so far the only one that's really handled the basketball besides Erica Ulrich. Into the corner. Margo steps back for three, decides no. Ulrich will dribble it to this side. Raven open for three, launches. No good. Keplocks runs it down, gets it ahead to Kamartha. Her layup, no good, and they're going to get Julie Raven for foul. I don't know about that, sports fans.
Man, you can hear the fans there. That should have been a definite no call. We'll look at it here on the replay and see if that agrees with it. Wow. Oh, absolutely no contact. I mean, I guess she was kind of bellied up, but if you can't even do that, then no sense in being on the floor.
Kamartha to the free throw line. Her first trip tonight. First one's good. So back on the free throw line and doing very well of the Lady Red Ravens. Have only missed one in the ballgame. Second one on the way by Kamartha is good.
Double digits for her. She's got an even 10. Coffeyville scores those first elusive points of the second half.
Looking inside to Courtney Hogue, wasn't there. Now to Alexander. Now they've got it to Hogue. Her shot off the rim. Backboard is good. Great offensive look by the Tigers.
Well, Courtney's got such a great touch with the ball. She, you know, her size, you'd think, gosh, she's going to come down and go back up strong with it. But and maybe it's those volleyball legs coming out. She's got great touch with it.
And on the other end, a defensive block by Courtney Hogue, and it bounces off of Kamartha out of bounds. Tiger basketball. We'll take a look at it here.
Courtney was able to get the block and was able to stay away from the body. And ooh, I don't know about that one, but maybe that was a makeup from the previous one. Nonetheless, we're even now. I guess we'll take it.
Pass in to Hogue. Lays it off the glass again, and a score. Courtney Hogue cutting to the rim.
Absolutely tremendous work by Courtney again. Great footwork catching the ball that time in movement, catching the ball for a big girl like that. Tremendous play by the 6'3 sophomore from Lawrence.
Tigers retake the lead. Long skip pass across to Cosper. Flip to the near side. Keplocks for a deuce. She got it.
Just two. The official flashed out. She's got 6 points. Ties it back up.
Maybe more lead changes in this thing than we can put down on a stat sheet. Going to be a bunch of them. Malabry kicks it to the near side. Tigers not getting in a big hurry here. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Hannah Alexander, the pull-up jumper, gets a shooter's roll. Her first two-point bucket of the night.
Well, she hasn't been on the floor a lot. Picked up those two fouls there early into the game and set out the majority of that first half.
Alexander's only played 6 minutes in the ballgame. Of course, 6 minutes of that first half, been in the last three here. Into the paint. They got to get it back out. Keplocks will shoot it. No good. Hogue with the rebound. Hogue protecting the basketball there. And Erica Ulrich slings it in the corner to Julie Raven. Raven steps back. She'll shoot it. Clanks off the nose of the iron. No good. Kamartha, the baseball pass ahead. Over to Curtis. Her shot up. No good. Rolls off the rim. But Courtney Hogue is going to pick up another foul.
Courtney may have got by with it if she didn't reach out with both hands, placed both hands on Kamartha. Probably what forced the call. We'll take a look at it right here. She was not too bad in both positions, but right there with two hands on her, and she knew it immediately because she raised them up.
Such a cheap foul. Get position and get in front. Free throw by Curtis again is good.
With her length, she doesn't have to be that close to block a shot either.
She doesn't. Second one by Curtis. Swirls out, no good. Rebound, Margot Malabray. Margo sets her feet for three. That one off the heel of the rim, no good. Erica Ulrich will reset it for the Tigers with a new shot clock. Here goes Margo inside. Shot up and good. Are we get a continuation or not? Yeah. No, they're not going to give her the continuation.
Tremendous drive on the baseline there by Margo. Going to the left hand. Good movement of ball by the Tigers. We'll take a look at it right here. Margo, just a quick crossover. Great seal off there as well by Courtney Hogue. Sealing the extra defender off. Just didn't, like Scott said, did not get the continuation.
Margo got the inbounds pass and the turn and shoot. And it's good for two.
Margo, 18 points in the ball game.
How huge is that? And a timeout called as the Tigers with a three-point lead. Let's take a quick timeout as well. We'll be right back here on the Cali Sports Network.
Patient first half, but she knew he was starting to get away from her already.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. Margo going for player of the week. Margo's going for player of the week in the conference.
She's got my vote. I don't know how that's picked or how they got to turn all that in or what, but.
Well, yeah, McCartney hasn't scored, but shoot, how many rebounds and steals and everything else she got?
And welcome back to the Cali Sports Network. We'll take a look at Malabre's shot from the corner off the inbounds, left completely alone, yeah.
Yeah, she was towing the line there, again, 3 inches, and she's got an extra point, but you know what? Points on every possession, that's what we'll take.
That'll pay the bills in the end. 49-46. I tell you what, Rainey brought it up there in the timeout, the way McCartney's playing. Anticipation of getting her back in the ball game is high.
What could happen when she does come back in? I mean, who knows, you know? Boy, she played defensively there in that last 5 minutes of that first half.
Keplock's inbound, Hogue guards it. Quick inbounds, and they get it quickly ahead. Kamartha, pass inside, stolen away, maybe not. Carranza finally gathers it back in. Flip to the corner, Cosper shot, good.
Nice release there from Cosper. She had Courtney Hogue outstretched in the air, reaching forward to try and block it. Still buried the mid-range shot.
Pass it into Alexander, they kick it back outside. That one tipped out of bounds off Keplock's hand.
Tell you, Hannah had a pretty good look from just inside the free throw line, didn't opt to shoot it.
Tell you what, the intensity level this game's being played at is furious. Raven over to Malabre, into Ulrich. The bounce pass down the baseline, pull up jumper by Alexander. She scores.
Great assist there from Erica. Gave a ball fake and then dished the backdoor cut.
Great play right there.
Extra pass. Get this Cali crowd into this thing. Tigers back up to a three-point lead. Lob pass tipped away by Malabre, but right back over to Kamartha.
Coffeyville does not have good spacing on their offensive set. We've got another turnover to the Tigers.
Another turnover, and our length again helping us out on that. Hannah, pull-up jumper off the window. It's no good. Cosper with the rebound.
I see that time there. Maybe Hannah forced one a little bit. Didn't have as open as a look as she did before, but shot that she's proven she can make.
Well, again, we've had some success, a lot of success with that extra pass. Can't get greedy here. Keplock's back outside. Pull-up jumper from the sideline. That's good for Curtis.
Just a pretty simple offensive set there for Caulfield, moving the ball through, playing through the paint. Getting an open look from the outside from Curtis.
Ulrich into the paint. Dishes to the near side. Tipped away by Keplocks, and she can't save it in time. Brown's going to come back in.
Good effort there by Keplocks. That actually was a pretty decent play from Eric. You got to credit Keplocks there for tipping that ball. Just about come up with a steal.
Raven inbounds it for Cali. Up one. 14:15 to go here in the ball game.
10 on the shot.
Raven nearly got that one stolen away. Malabre got to look for an open player. 5-4. Raven forces one. Won't go. Ray rebound to Carranza. Not a good possession for the Tigers there. Kamartha, her shot no good. Stolen away. on the rebound by Carranza. She dribbles it out of bounds. Lucky break for the Tigers there. And we'll take everyone we can get.
Absolutely. Jade Carranza right there from Wichita. To look up, see what high school she played at Wichita. But she's impressed me here through this ball game today. Scrapper on the floor, much like our Riley McCartley, Bailey Floor, that kind of a style of player.
Margot shot for three. Three ball, corner pocket. It's good. She's got 21, ladies and gentlemen.
Wow.
Coach Todd says move the ball. She did, right through the hoop.
Yes, she did.
Moved it right through. I like that.
There's all kinds of movement on it. Carranza with the ball inside again. Lost the handle on it. Back outside the goal. 15 on the shot clock. Drive to the bucket by Curtis. Blocked by Courtney Hogue. Here come the Tigers quickly ahead. Courtney's got it. Had it go right through her hands.
How about the effort, though, from Courtney getting the block and being the first player back down the other end to catch the ball. You love that.
Pass a little behind her on her back shoulder. They got it out in front of her. Ulrich would have just tipped it a little bit further in front of her. I think she'd have had it an easy layup.
Well, you just can't take enough, though, away from that effort. I mean, it's just.
Kurt's right. For a big girl, Courtney runs the floor really, really well.
She does. A little stronger in the hands. There's the ball thrown away. Julie Ravens got it. Goes in for a right-hand layup. Easy one. Oh, and she misses it. My goodness. Wow, you couldn't ask for a better opportunity there for Julie Raven. Coach Clark with his hands on the back of his head going, you got to be kidding me.
I think she was too open.
Yep. Keplocks, her shot in there, and she got a block called on Erica Ulrich. And wow, freight train came through there, and the back tag had Keplocks written all over it.
Erica pops up, smile on her face as usual.
Wow.
Ooh, I don't know. She was. I guess that's why we're not wearing striped shirts, huh?
I reckon that's why we're analysts and not officials.
I took a referee class one time. It's all about the angle that the referee sees it at.
There you go. Keplocks misses the first free throw. Coffeyville not shooting as crisply from the line as they were in the first half. Second one for Keplocks. It does drop.
But still only three misses from the line in the ball game.
And the Tigers continue the shooting. And here comes a couple of new charges off the bench. For the Tigers, Raven with it. She'll penetrate to Hogue from the free throw line. It's good. Courtney Hogue with the range. She's got double digits.
Tell you what, she stepped her game up. We keep her out of foul trouble. She's done a pretty good job of doing that so far. We keep her out of foul trouble. Could be a big difference maker in this game.
Camartha with the basketball. Looking up top to Chantel Smith. They'll back it off. Lob passes. More ticks gone away on the clock. Here comes Brown outside. Inside, Smith drives. Shot up no good, but Courtney Ho came down with the arm.
She did get the ball, but got the arm as well after the ball was released.
Yeah, third foul on Courtney Hogue, and that's big.
I just talked about it and probably jinxed her on that, but.
Yeah, she just shouldn't have brought that arm down. I think she had enough disturbance in the shot that she probably would have not hit it. Smith goes to the free throw line. She's now 3 of 3.
A couple new players coming in for the Tigers here. Obviously, Riley McCartney in the game. Maddie Greenwood back in as well.
Smith back to the free throw line. That one off the mark. Rebound by Ulrich. Greenwood with the ball, open from the corner, just off the mark, tipped away. McCartney tipped it again, but couldn't come down with it. Smith with it, in transition, ahead to Curtis. See what the Red Ravens try to do here. The Tigers packed around the paint. Outside three, on the way, short, coming back in it. Camartha, she can't get it, the Tigers do. Here comes Ulrich. She'll pull it up. Wise decision.
Smart move.
Greenwood penetrates, kicks it back outside, the block shot. Great job by Maddie Greenwood drawing a foul.
Well, I talked about it. You know, can we get those legs tired from Coffeyville? That time there, Carranza just got beat on the first step, tried to make up for it. You see it right there, and did a good job of keeping her hands up. Didn't place her hands on Maddie, but just gave her a pretty good body check. Tigers got to get a second chance here and turn it into points.
Malabray's three, no good. Tipped away by Ulrich. Picked up by Hannah Alexander. Shoots. Oh, and won't score. She had it. It just rolls off the rim.
Good work by Hannah, though, to not want to kick that ball back out and go right back at it. Didn't really have a great look, an open look, I should say, but made something out of it. And drew another foul, this time on Essence Brown.
Take a look at it here. Great release.
Actually, you know, her open, she was more open than I thought. Looking at that angle right there, she had a real good look at it.
Alexander's fifth of the night. Going for number six. That one hard off the back of the iron, no good. So one for two is Hannah Alexander. 11 minutes left to play. Tigers up by five. Kick it to the other side. Here comes Smith down the paint. Blocked by Ulrich. Picked up by Malabry. She'll push it ahead. All the way in for the right-hand layup. She's got it up and in. Margo Malabry, 23 points.
And again, all started from the other end of the block shot. We may get another one.
Brown drives the lane. Her shot no good. Ulrich picks up another rebound for the Tigers. Ahead to Margo. She'll stop the ball, get it to McCartney, and the Tigers will reset the offense. Margo, spark plug. McCartney shot, no good. Battle for the rebound. McCartney pulls it away from Carranza. Hannah Alexander helping out there. That one on the way from Malabray, no good.
Boy, Tigers got a second chance there. Just couldn't get it to fall. Riley McCartney doing again what she does. Didn't give up on that rebound and stole it away. I'm considering that a rebound for Coffeyville and a steal for her.
Drive inside by Camartha, no good, but a foul called. That one's going to be on Erica Ulrich, her second.
And we're going to take a look at it right here. Again, ball on the perimeter. Was she set? It was close. Probably not.
Nap got into her with a hip. And a timeout called by Coffeyville. They'll take a full timeout. We'll take one as well. Media timeout, 59-52. Tigers with the lead. We'll be back.
Well, I tell you, what could have McKenzie added this game if she would have been able to play? I mean, another player to scrap around out there? Wow. 59-52. I'll get the stat sheet here to see here. Probably turnover still. I've got him for 21 turnovers, but let me look for sure when he get. Oh, for Cali? Welcome back to WS Scott Auditorium. Tigers with a 7-point lead here halfway through the second half. And I tell you what, Tigers so far here in this second half have come out after finishing 37.5%, 15 of 40 in the first half from the floor, come out and raise that up to 42% here in the second half. And they've held Coffeyville to 3 of 10. And they also attempted another 3-point shot to Coffeyville. Have not made that. So on the game, they're 0 of 2. Your Tigers are 8 of 25 from beyond the arc. And I don't know, interesting stat from this first half, I guess, so far. Would have to be Margo Malabry. 23 points, 5 of 10 from beyond the arc, 9 of 16 overall. Is Margo. Hasn't attempted a free throw. They've all come from the field as well.
That is correct. Back to the free throw. Camartha misses her first one of the night. Just a 51% free throw shooter on the season. Missed the first and missed the second as well, but goes in for the rebound. Tigers had it blocked out, but couldn't get it. McCartney goes the rebound. Camartha comes down with another one.
Maybe Camartha was challenged during that last timeout from Coach Emily Washburn. So far, she's coming out and controlling the game here on this trip down the floor.
There's Cosper from the corner. Got it. Her 9th point of the night.
Only been a quiet 9 points for Cosper. We talked about it. Don't want her to get heated up here in this last 10 minutes of play.
Definitely not. Here comes Raven. Sets it outside to McCartney. 14 on the shot clock. Back inside to Hannah Alexander. Three on the way. Off the mark. No good. Tipped out of bounds by Coffeyville's Kamartha.
Well, Tigers had a good look that time. Just a bad release out of the hands of Julie Raven. Hannah Alexander's working hard down low, trying to get posted up against Curtis. Got a height advantage there. 5'9 is Curtis.
Ball thrown inside. Boy, Hannah didn't look like she saw it coming as it ricochets off. But McCartney there to save the possession for the Tigers. Back outside to Raven. Here comes the double team. Wide open is Malabray for three. No good. McCartney over the back of her was Carranza. No call. 4-point advantage for the Tigers here. 8:43 to go. Cosper will line up a three to launch it, and it's good. Like you said, Kurt, can't let her get hot here.
Two made threes, and just like that, she's got 12, and her team's down by just one now.
Going to be a game of runs. Here comes Greenwood in for a layup. No. Two missed layups by the Tigers here. And carrying the ball, called a turnover as Curtis gets whistled for the infraction.
She came out getting that rebound at Curtis and was trying to wrap it and immediately turn it and go down the floor with it. Called for the rolling the ball over. Tigers will take it. We need some points right here.
Huge possession for the Tigers. Got to come away with some numbers. Open baseline look. Out to McCartney. That one nearly stole one. Gathered in by Alexander. She puts it off the window and it won't go. That one tipped out of bounds off of Keplocks.
Well, Hannah had a good inside position. Just didn't get the ball up off the glass on the right spot. Got to keep working hard down there.
Another three off the mark by the Tigers there. Malabray can't hit. Empty possession for the Tigers. About third in a row, if I remember right.
I think so, and it's come from shots. Just not falling for the Tigers.
Bunny shots, yeah. Too. There's a drive inside. Bounce pass low for Carranza. She's not going to miss that shot.
Points for Carranza. Official stop action there just a little bit. Get Carranza and Riley McCartney together. Well, maybe they were bumping down the floor. I don't think there was much there, but official thought there was maybe.
Here come the Tigers. Down by one. 60-59. Pass into McCartney. Right back out. Here comes Alexander in the paint. Her shot no good. Rebound. Foul going to be on McCartney.
Boy, another play where the Tigers got the ball in deep but cannot finish. That old bunny shot, as Scott calls it. Great look down low. Kiplock's got the block.
A lid on the basket for the Tigers so far.
Yep. Second foul on Riley.
Lob pass ahead. Tigers got to find some of that mojo they had in the first half, Randy. Ooh, here comes Keplocks down the baseline. Flips it back up top. Drive to the rim and a score by Curtis.
And they're getting those easy shots. They're getting the ball in the paint like we are. They're going down for them and they're not for us. Tigers got to turn it around.
Well, they're not trying to drive through traffic. They're going around it. Raven for the two. Good. Tigers needed that big.
Cowie needed that.
12.
In the tie a little bit. Get this right there.
There's a steal. Maddie Greenwood's got it. Kicks it ahead to Julie Raven. That one's stolen back by Keplocks. The Tigers got in a hurry. Coffeyville back on the offensive. Pass down on the low blocks again. Carranza's got it and scores. 18 for Carranza. Averages 5.7 points a game. Ouch.
She's been their player of the game, obviously.
Greenwood again goes to the rim. She'll draw a foul.
I think it's going to be on Cosper. That should be two on her. And it is. Free throws here. How many times have we said free throws are going to be a difference in a ball game?
More than once.
More than once, and it's not going to make any difference here in this ball game, I'm sure.
Maddie doesn't take much time, just throws her up there, and that one unfortunately bounces her own way for the Tigers. Her first miss of the night from the line. Doesn't take a lot of time to think about it, just gets to work. Greenwood with another opportunity here. And it goes.
Tigers get some size back on the floor. Is Erica Ulrich, Courtney Hogue back in the game for the Tigers. Brylee New also back in.
Four sophomores and five sophomores, if I remember right.
Yeah.
Calibre, transfer. Down by two of the Tigers. Coffeyville moving around the perimeter, have been going inside. Let's see if they get an open look here. Pull up jumper. That went off the mark. Hogue tried to get the rebound, tipped it away right into the hands of Cosper. She scores.
Got to secure the rebound, can't tip it.
New. Inside and back out, lost the handle on it, stolen away. A travel, probably called there. That one kicked. That's going to roll out of the bounds and Tiger basketball. But not looking good. A little out of sorts of the Tigers there.
I want to say panic, but we just need to take a deep breath here to the Tigers. And go back to running their stuff offensively here and getting some good looks. We've had good looks. Got to get away to make them a fall, though, as well.
Down by four of the Tigers. Malibre could change it in a hurry, though. Again, a little confusion on the basketball. Ooh, and that one nearly thrown away. He's got to clean it up here a little bit. Straight through. Alexander's open under the rim, shoots and scores.
Good job by Hannah there to protect the ball. Had a big swat of the ball coming from the Coffeyville defender and protected it with her body.
Great pass, though. Found her underneath. Tigers just down by two here. Under five to play. Again, they go into paint. And Coffeyville's going to turn it back over to the Tigers here.
That time, Carranza just rushed herself. Got the ball, knew she had Courtney Hogue behind her, didn't catch the entry pass, tried to get it back out. Yeah, no, that wasn't even close. That about went in the front row here at W.S. Scott Auditorium. Tigers with an opportunity, Scott. Can we turn it into points like we did in the first half?
Alexander looking inside, gets the screen away, pull up jumper from the side, no good. Good looking shot, just couldn't get it up, just didn't get it up high.
Yeah, a little flat, a little short, a little flat.
Tigers needed that possession.
I'll tell you what, Cosper that time got the ball across midcourt. 9 seconds. It was 21 when she walked across midcourt.
Cosper dribbles, steps back, three on the way. Good. Cosper has missed a shot.
Nope.
Here in the last 10 minutes. Bounce pass inside to Ho. She'll go up and get fouled. They're going to get, I believe, 21 Curtis for her first. Sure enough.
Could have been on Kamartha from the backside. Would have been her third.
Sticks Hogue to the free throw line. And it's good. Courtney with 11 points. Height back on the court for Coffeyville. She got Kamars and Keplocks. Courtney's second on the way and good as well. So a three-point ball game. Oh, marked the wrong one. 12 points for Courtney Hogue. 69-66. We'll step away for just a minute. We'll be back. My goodness. A three-point lead for the Lady Red Ravens with 4:08 left to go here in this one. And Kirk, Randy, both of them. This has been a knockdown dragout, to say the least.
It absolutely has. It's a game that the Tigers, last 5 minutes of play, Scott, just haven't been able to make shots. I mean, it's not that they haven't had good looks. Yeah, they've had a couple turnovers that shouldn't have, but they haven't been able to make shots.
Kamartha with it off a quick inbounds pass. Shot up, no good, but a foul. Margo's going to pick up another one. Her third, I believe. Back to the free throw line we go.
They called that on Courtney.
What?
was on Courtney.
Oh, wow. Let's look at that one again.
Well, they posted up four for her, only had her for three.
She slapped down on her.
Free throw on the way by Camarthers, no good. Okay, hack on the shoulder, I guess, okay.
What do you have her for, three or four?
I've got her for four.
Okay, I missed one.
Second shot on the way. That one goes in. 4-point advantage, under four to play. Tigers got to get it together here. Comes Ulrich into the paint, shoots, and it goes out of bounds. Again, a forced shot that the Tigers didn't need to take. Stepping away from what they've been doing all game long into a game that's just not theirs.
Matty Greenwood's going to come up off the bench here for the Tigers.
Again, Tigers in the full court defense. Back off to half court. Cosper with it. Looking inside again. They'll go back outside. Keplock's drive, shoots, and scores, and one. Getting to the rim where we're not.
Yeah, sure. Nice play there by Keplock. A little ball fake. Got us in the air.
Riding we're reacting to the ball fake, and they haven't hardly shot outside all night. We need to stay down, play good D, and get a stop.
Keplock converts the three-point play. We got her for 10. So do I. Here we go. Malibre. Back outside. McCartney will shoot the three. Good. Tigers needed that one big time.
Riley's first release from beyond the arc today, where she lit it up at Allen County on Wednesday night. So you expect it. A lot of her shots were from about that exact same spot on the floor in Iola.
Full timeout taken. We'll take it as well. Tigers down by four. We'll be back. We're going to have to get back into it with a three, or we're going to start taking much better shots inside.
Yeah.
I mean, they're taking two-footers in here right off the backboard, and we're not.
Yeah, we'd hit a couple layups there. We wouldn't have this problem.
Yeah. Welcome back to the Cali Sports Network and our Kansas City, Cali County Community College. Inside W.S. Scott Auditorium on Dan Kaler Court. In the timeout, Tigers down by four, but a great shot by McCartney right there at the top of key gets the Tigers back that close.
Yeah, back within four. It had been 5-6. It was obviously at 7 there. Randy said it right there during the break. We were talking off air. He said, you know, they're getting easy shots down low and making them. And he had a good point as well. Biting on the ball fake when they haven't made anything. Now they've been shooting the ball down in the paint, getting it to the rim. We're biting on a ball fake. Of course, you get excited. You want to try to get the ball back. You're going to go at everything. They're going to flash at you. But got to settle down and play some defense right here and try and get a steal.
Cosper's got it. Takes it across the stripe. All the way into the paint. Lob shot. In. Look at that. When it goes, it goes. She's got 19. Got her average. What did she have? She had four at the break, if I remember right.
I think that's right.
One thing we said the Tigers can't allow to happen has happened. McCartney. Red Ravens doing a good job at guarding the basketball in the perimeter. Weave by the Tigers. Loose basketball. Coffeyville's got it. Quickly ahead. Cosper lays it in for two.
Wow, it's gone from bad to worse all of a sudden for the Tigers.
Getting away from the Tigers. Just, you know, there's 2.5 left. Don't have to get crazy here and start taking bad shots. Raven top of the notch. No good. Shot clock down to 12. Raven launches one. Short. Gathered in by McCartney. She scores. Timeout quickly called by Coach Clark. He'll take a full 60-second timeout. Let's stay right here as the Tigers are down by six with 2:15 to go. Randy, you talked about it at the break. Tigers getting away from what brought them to this point. where Coffeyville just kept pounding it inside, scoring like they pretty much started out in the first of the game. The Tigers have got to get back on the mark with some, hopefully some made threes, but they haven't been able to get open.
Well, they haven't been open. The other thing to think of as well is Lady Tigers had committed 5 turnovers through the whole first half. They've got 10 now in the game, but they've come at inopportune times for the Lady Tigers. The other thing is we have not been able to force them. They've got 21 turnovers, actually 24 turnovers now. I was looking at that media time. We got 24 turnovers, but we have not been able to turn their turnovers into points like we did in that first half when we went on that 29-11 run to finish up with and get it tied back up. Just hasn't happened here in the second half for the Lady Tigers.
There's still time to get it done. Just got to score in every possession and get some valuable, valuable turnovers here in the next 2 minutes and 15 seconds.
Well, the other thing is, we talked about all the time, the three-point shot, how it just changed the game. A couple threes up here by the Tigers, which is not out of the question at all with the players we have on the floor. A couple of quick threes up, and you're right back tied up in this game.
Coffeyville gets the ball inbounded. Cosper turns it over. Tigers got it back. Great job by Maddie Greenwood on the floor after the basketball. Now we got to come away with points. Greenwood's got it. She takes an open look at three. No. Rebound, long rebound. Comes off to Keplox. Now wide open at Cosper for an easy layup on the right-hand side.
Well, hey, you're going to see the finishing stat line of this game, and Cosper's going to have obviously 20-plus. She's got 23 now, but you'd have never known it at halftime.
Absolutely true. Malibray comes in, shoots one off the window. That's no good. Hannah Alexander and Malibray collide, and Tigers keep the basketball. Here comes Bradley New. She goes down the baseline, steps on the baseline, and turns it over.
Rushing, trying, forcing, which obviously after you're down to 90 seconds left in the game, you're down by 8, but just needed a little more real estate there, did Riley New.
Bounce pass into Camartha. Keplox will stroke it down the left side. Looking to score quickly have been Coffeyville the whole game long. I think they'll burn some time off the clock here. Appears to be what they're going to do as Camartha backs off. 11 on the shot clock. 109 to play in the ball game. Camartha in, passes off underneath. Curtis can't score. And Hannah Alexander's going to come away with a rebound here, but wow. Down by 8 with 1 minute to go.
Foul on Camartha right there. Foul she really didn't have to commit. No free throws though yet for the Tigers. Next foul it will be.
Greenwood's got to bring it up and bring it up quick. Tigers got to score in a hurry. McCartney's open top of the key. No good. Rebound comes off to Camartha. I think she would foul right away. You can hear Coach Clark saying foul, foul, foul. Keplox brings it up and she's finally fouled with 43.7 to go.
Boy, when the old shooting goes south, it went south quick for the Tigers. And obviously, Coffeyville turned it up.
Tigers were down by 2 with 5 minutes to play, 64-66, and it just steadily, one possession after another, gotten away from Cali here with 43 seconds to go. Free throw line is Keplox. That one ricochets off, no good. Malibray with a rebound. There comes Margo into the paint, lays it off the glass, good. There's the point, the shots we needed to drop about 6 minutes ago. Down by 6, 35.6 left. A timeout, 30-second timeout called, or was it a minute? Cheerleaders are on the court.
And both benches are up, so I'm sure it's just a 30.
Let's just stay right here on the Cali Sports Network. A momentum game, to say the least. As we look at the Jayhawk Eastern standings, Coffeyville at 2-0, Tigers at 1-1. Needed to even this one up big time.
Well, aside from the rivalry of the game as well, like you said, it's a key early matchup here because this is, you'd expect Cali and Coffeyville to be towards the top, if not at the top, of the Division I standings in the East come the end of the season. So, you hate to have to try and get even with them on the road at their place.
Yes. That little gym fills up fast and gets loud in a hurry.
Yes, it does.
35.6 ticks left on the clock. Coffeyville will have the basketball 90 feet away. Up by six. McCartney guards the inbounds. Carranza to inbound. And a 5-second call. No, they got a timeout. Are you kidding me? Coach Washburn. Wow, I don't know about that, sports fan. 1 minute timeout called. Let's go ahead and take a quick timeout and we'll be back. Wow. We got a shot from Cameron, or Kevin's camera on there.
Did they give her the timeout before the 5 seconds?
I guess so. Welcome back to the Cali Sports Network. Coffeyville and Cali. Coffeyville with a 6-point lead and a questionable call right there, as was the timeout called before the 5-second violation. Courtney Hogue's going to come in to guard the inbounds here. I'm not sure how many timeouts there are left by either team. Keplock's to inbound it. Finally gets it in. And we're going to get a foul called here. Officials are discussing it. Going to get it on, I believe, Hannah Alexander, her fourth. Oh, they just got her for three. Oh, I did mark another one. Marked the wrong one a while ago.
Well, we got the quick foul like we wanted. I think maybe we had a tie up there as well. There was a collision for the ball, but the ball was thrown in an awkward spot. You got to give the defensive player an opportunity to get it as well.
First free throw's no good. Back Leetrace Curtis. Courtney Hogue's comes back out of the ball game. McCartney, Greenwood, Raven, Malibre, and Alexander on the court for the Tigers. Second one on the way. It's good. Here comes Maddie Greenwood. Pushes it right up Main Street. Looks for the screen. That one partially evidently blocked, I believe, on the call. And then we're going to get a foul.
And a set play there, trying to get the ball to, obviously, Julie Raven. Maddie Greenwood ran in front of her. Kind of a peel-off screen, if you will. Unfortunately, once again, that's been the story of the game. The shot didn't go down. That's the most important part.
To the free throw line is Curtis. First one is good. I've got her for 12 points, 6 of 8. Am I close?
I've got her for 14.
And
I think I gave player the wrong point, so we'll double check it.
Here come the Tigers with 20 seconds left to go. Malibre into the paint, shot up, no good. Attempted save by Hannah Alexander, not there. Keplox will inbound again, and McCartney will guard it. 17 seconds left to go here on the clock. And we've got a baseline violation by Keplox and the Tigers.
And it wasn't a made bucket, so she couldn't run the baseline. Tigers catch a break, but is there enough time left? There's only 17 left.
And a full timeout taken with 17.1 to go. 73-82. Coffeyville with the lead. Let's take a break. We'll be right back. Too little time, too big a deficit.
Yeah.
We're going to have to get some four-pointers. I don't see that happening. Yeah. The Tigers down to Coffeyville here on Dan Kaler Court. Huge protect your floor. Well, and I believe there's too little time to get that done.
Something else. Obviously, you hate to say it, but this is going to be the Lady Tigers' first loss on Dan Kaler Court this year.
That's true.
10-0 coming into today's game right here on this floor.
Don't forget to catch the EA Sports postgame show coming up immediately following this game. Alexander inbounds, looking back inside. Here comes Malibre. She throws one up and it drains. Malibre with 7 now. And an immediate foul on Keplocks by Julie Raven. Raven's going to pick up her second foul, and the Tigers down by 7. We'll give it up to Emily Washburn and her Lady Red Ravens.
They weathered the storm of the Tigers because the Tigers dominated that last 10 minutes of the first half. They found a way to battle through it, and they really controlled the first 10 minutes of the half. Second half, though, has just been a battle between both teams.
Second one on the way, and it's good as well, 84-75. 10 seconds to go, Malibre penetrates, and a foul called on Chantel Smith. Well, so Malibre get a chance to add to her stat sheet with a couple of free throws here. Well, 1-1 anyway. No, she'll get a couple here. No, she won't. Just 7 fouls, so it was a 1-1. 4 seconds left, now 3, a foul called. Carranza's gonna get a chance to go to the free throw line, and this one just could not take any more time to get over with. A 9-point lead for the Lady Red Ravens. Bronza misses the first. Her first miss of the night from the stripe. 6 of 7. 18 points. Second one no good as well. Here comes Alexander. Launches one at half court. And it's no good. That's the final buzzer, folks. Your Tigers drop this one 75-84 to Coffeyville. A big loss for the Tigers. We'll take a break. We'll come back. The EA Sports postgame show coming up right after this.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for joining us, Randy.
Right,
you bet.
I gotta go get a grandson.
There you go. Zach, are we going to have coach right away or what? Yeah, he's going to the locker room, so. Okay, sounds good. I'm going to go get stats.
Yep.